Hello everyone, this is Vita Priya from R&D Engineering College. In this lecture, we'll be discussing about keys in DBMS. So key is an attribute or set of attributes that can uniquely identify an entire row in the database. For example, you consider you're having a table with 10 records. If you want to identify a row uniquely, or if you want to retrieve a row with a unique value, you should have a keys there. That means one or multiple columns as a key value there. Keys in sense, it is going to uniquely identify your records. So there are various types of key available in DBMS. They are candidate key, composite, primary, alternative and foreign key. So candidate key. So in this table, you consider the table here, student ID, roll number, first name, last name and emails are the attributes of this table. So here, which attributes are a unique value means the student ID is a unique value here. Also, the roll number is a unique value. Email is also a unique value. Your first name and last name cannot play a unique value or unique constraint here because names may be repeated for two or more people. So here, whichever columns are unique here, everything will be considered as a candidate key here. You can either go with one single column or the combination of one or more columns. So for example, here the candidate keys are student ID, roll number, email, and also the combination of these three. Combination in sense, student ID plus roll number is a candidate key, or student ID plus email is a candidate key, roll number plus email is a candidate key. So, or student ID, roll number and email are either three columns put together forms a candidate key here. The candidate key is nothing but whichever column is a unique column in the table, either the single column or the combination of all the unique columns is considered as a candidate key. The next one is composite key. Here, composite key in sense, consider the table. Here, subject, student ID, subject ID, mark and exam name. So, when you are trying to insert the mark here, you cannot go with the student ID. Suppose you are taking student ID alone as a unique value or unique column here. So student ID is a unique column here. I am going to insert a mark. Only by having a student ID, you cannot insert the mark. If a student may be enrolled or student may write the exam for multiple subjects, so you must know the subject ID also. So, whenever entering the mark along with the student ID, subject ID is also necessary for entering the mark. Or else, the second example, you are considering only the subject ID as a unique column. With that unique column, you cannot insert the marks because for that particular subject, for which student you are going to enter the mark, we don't know. So, put together, student ID and subject ID plays a unique column here. So, that thing will be called as a composite key. So composite key in sense, this combination only plays the role of composite key. Whenever we are dividing this column as two, we cannot retrieve a unique value there because in the composite key, only two rows will be playing the role of unique columns or composite key. Whenever you are trying to divide it or separate the two columns, it will not provide you a unique value. So this is your composite key. So whenever you know the subject ID as well as the student ID, you will be able to enter the mark. For example, student 1 for the subject ID 101, this is the mark. For student 2, the subject code is 202 and the mark you can enter. So whenever you are considering both the columns as a key here, you will be getting a unique value. If you are separating, it cannot provide you a meaningful value there. The next one is primary key. The candidate key, we saw that either one column or combination of two or more column gives you a candidate key. But in the primary key, in a table, only one row will be, one column will be considered as a primary key. In this example, either you can go with student ID or roll number or email ID. From among these three columns, you can make any one column as a primary key here. So primary key is a unique column for retrieving a particular row in a table. So alternative key, in the among the candidate key, one column will be considered as a primary key and the left other columns will be called as a alternative key. So primary key is nothing but among candidate key, any one column will be uniquely, that is among three unique columns, one column will be considered as a primary key and the rest of the columns will be considered as an alternative keys. So whenever you are creating a table, it is mandatory that the table should contain a primary key. At least one column should be uniquely provided. The next one is foreign key. So we'll go with an example here. So customer is a table one and the second table is order here. So customer table is going to act as a base table here and this is the foreign table. So in the base table customer, the attributes are customer number, first name and last name. And in the order table, the attributes are order number, employee number, customer number, supplier, price and the item. So we created a table customer with the primary key customer number. As I told, whenever you are going to create a table, at least one column, that is it should have a primary key, at least one column should be uniquely identifiable. So customers, customer number is a primary key. For this table, you are going to create the another one table. So whenever you are creating a relatively other table, at least one column should be common among both the table. So from the customers and orders table, the common column is customer number. So in customer number, it is a primary key. In orders table, customer number is going to act as a foreign key. You may ask which one will be acting as a primary key for orders. So as I said, whenever you are creating a table, one column should be a primary key. So here you will be going with order number as a primary key. So here we are talking about the foreign key. So directly we will be going there. So customer number is a foreign key in the orders table. So whenever you are creating a foreign key in the foreign table, that foreign key should act as a primary key in your base table. So this is the major constraint of creating a foreign key. I'll repeat again. So in the customers table, customer number is a primary key. When you are creating a foreign table orders, customer number is going to act as a foreign key. So to act as a foreign key, the first constraint is this foreign key should be a primary key in the base table. So that's how you will be joining two tables together by creating a foreign key. So primary key is nothing but a unique column identifiable for that particular table. And foreign key is for providing a relation between two tables. You will be mapping one column as a common column for both the table. In the foreign table, that common column will be called as a foreign key. So this is your foreign key. So in this lecture, we saw what various keys of what is candidate key, composite key, primary and alternative key, and foreign key. Thank you.